Hello children, so we meet again. Today we will be continuing with the same topic, subject verb agreement. We have discussed certain points in the earlier class. We will continue with the further points or the uses of subject verb agreement in this class also. And I would like you to keep a pen and paper ready, because after the completion of the chapter, we will be giving you certain exercises based on the same topic. Children, in the last session, we had discussed till point 9. Let's further move with the 10th use of subject verb agreement. There are certain words with when joined with two singular subjects, they take a singular verb. Let's take for here, when two or more singular subjects are connected by, with, together with, and not, besides, no less than, then the verb will be singular in form. Let's for example take the suitcase with all its content was stolen. Now in this example, the suitcase is one singular thing. The contents are plural, but suitcase is singular. Thus it takes a singular verb. The next example, Rajesh together with his friends is present. No one besides the nurse knows the secret. He and not you is to blame. So let's see the next point. There are certain sentences which begin with there. In such sentences, the verb agrees with the number of noun that follows it. Let's take for example, there are 40 boys in my class. Now here the noun is boys, which is plural in number. Therefore, we use the verb are in the sentence. The second example, there is no leaf on the tree. Now here, leaf is singular. Therefore, we use singular verb, that is in the sentence. There were more than 100 people in the party. Some nouns which are plural in form but singular in meaning take a singular verb. Plural in form like our subjects, let's take for example mathematics, economics, words like news, wages, they already are plural but the meaning is singular. That's why they take a singular verb always. For example, mathematics is a difficult subject to understand. Economics is my favorite subject. This news is false. So in the last example, if we take new, the meaning changes. New means naya, but news means some news. The next point is, plural nouns which indicate the name of a country, province or title of some book take a singular verb, because they also refer to a singular subject only. For example, the United States has a fine navy. The Arabian Nights contains many interesting stories. Great Expectations is an interesting novel. All these name of places or the name of books, they are singular, one. So they take a singular verb. The next point is, when there is a collective noun as a subject, they take a singular verb. But when the subject stands for the collection as a whole, but it takes a plural noun when the subject stands for the individuals of which it is composed. So now I repeat my point here. When we are talking about the subject collectively as a whole, that is a collection of things or a collective noun, it takes a singular verb, it is referred to as singular. But when we are talking of individual items or individual things that collection is made of, then it would take a plural noun or plural verb. Let's take for example, the jury has 4 members. The jury have different opinions. Now in both these examples, the first one refers to the jury as a whole, collective noun. But in the second example, the jury We are referring to the members of the jury. Third example, the council has elected its president. The crew were arrested. So there are certain words or nouns which are singular in form but plural in meaning. So they always take a plural verb. For example, cattle are grazing. People were fighting in the streets yesterday. Let's see the next point. When the subject of a verb is a relative pronoun, let's for example, what relative pronouns are, who, whom, which, that, what, then the verb agrees with the antecedent of the relative pronoun. Now here what antecedent is? Antecedent actually refers to some event which comes before some other event which is about to happen. Matlab, कोई एक काम जो आगे एक काम से होने वाला पहले होने वाला है. Let's for example, it is he who is to blame. He has sold the cow which gives milk. It is Ram who is knocking at the door. The last point is, there are certain nouns which always are in plural form and therefore they take plural verbs only. Certain words like pants, shorts, spectacles, drawers, trousers, tweezers, scissors, etc., which already have a s added, and they seem that they are plural because there are two parts to it. Like if we talk about pants, there are two legs to the pants, so they are considered to be plural. Thus they always take a plural verb with them. Children, with this we end with the topic subject verb agreement, and I'll be giving you certain practice exercises. Children, please get a pen and copy ready to note down these exercises which you need to do in your copies. So this is the first practice exercises which you need to note down in your copies. Second exercise. The exercise is based on editing. And in the first question, this sentence is continued. The third exercise is this. In this, you need to correct the following sentences. There is a mistake in the sentence. Children, with this, we complete a topic subject-verb agreement, and we'll meet with a new topic in the next class. Thank you.